While browsing the web, we see these checkboxes and puzzles that ask us to prove that we are not robots.
This year even Mark Zuckerberg took one of these tests before an interview, and he passed. So this begs the question, can these tests even keep robots away? Well, to find out, let's talk about CAPTCHAs.
In 2000, Yahoo was one of the most popular email providers, and they had a problem. People were creating automatic bots that were making millions of free email accounts and then using them to send around spams. And Yahoo didn't know how to stop them. Louis Fanon, that was a PhD student in computer science, came up with an idea to show distorted images of random characters and ask people to type them in. He called it CAPTCHA, completely automated public Turing test to tell computers and humans apart. And it was a success. You see, back then, computers weren't that good at optical character recognition, aka OCR. But humans, we thought to ourselves from a really young age how to read. We can read different handwritings in different light conditions from different angles. So CAPTCHA was really successful in keeping bots away. And every day, roughly 200 million CAPTCHAs were solved around the world. But Fanon wasn't that happy with the situation.
He thought to himself that it takes 10 seconds for an average user to type in a CAPTCHA. So roughly every day, 500,000 hours of humans' brains and lives were just wasted on typing some random, useless characters. So a few years later, he came up with ReCAPTCHA and used it to digitize old books.
There are two steps to digitize a document. First is to scan the document and turn it into an image. And the second one is to use OCR and turn the image into text. That's where ReCAPTCHA stepped in. You see, instead of showing random characters to the user, ReCAPTCHA would ask the user to type in two words. The first one was a control. It was a randomly selected word that the user had to get it right in order to pass the test. But the second one, it was coming from scans of old documents that the system wasn't sure about. And after enough people typed in the same word, the answer would get locked in and added to the archives. Google liked the idea of ReCAPTCHA and bought it in 2009. They then used it to digitize books for Google Books and the archives of the New York Times from 1851. And when they ran out of those, they used it to improve Google Maps services. But ReCAPTCHA couldn't last long in keeping bots away.
First of all, there are online services that their job is just to solve CAPTCHAs. So bots can go around the internet and do whatever they want. And whenever a CAPTCHA shows up, they can forward the CAPTCHA to those services. These services hire people from low-income countries and ask them to just sit behind a computer and solve CAPTCHAs throughout the whole day.
Some people came up with a different idea. They made some websites with some non-family friendly content. And whenever a user wanted to visit their website, they had to type in some CAPTCHAs. CAPTCHAs that were directly copied from websites that the bots were trying to break into. But worse than all was the advance of AI. You see, over years, computers got better in solving CAPTCHAs. And actually, CAPTCHA makers had to come up with harder CAPTCHAs to be ahead of the game. But at some point, CAPTCHAs became so hard that people couldn't solve them anymore, but computers could. In 2014, Google ran a test and saw that their AI system could solve CAPTCHAs with 99.8% accuracy, but humans could only solve it with 33% accuracy. So at this point, CAPTCHAs were actually punishing humans instead of keeping bots away. So Google released ReCAPTCHA version 2, and it actually shows these boxes of "I'm not a robot" to the user. After clicking the box, Google gets some extra data about the user, like the country and the IP of the user. Also some data about the user behavior, like how the user moves the mouse before clicking the box, or maybe how the user taps the screen. Google then gives all of this data to a machine learning model to figure out if a user is human or robot. So if a user is in incognito mode or using some sort of VPN, they are more likely to fail the test. Then Google asked to solve these puzzles to find images of traffic lights or cars. This was working in 2014 because AI wasn't advanced in image recognition, but these days it's not that hard to train a model to solve this puzzle. Or still it's possible to ask services online to use human to solve the puzzles. So in 2018 enters ReCAPTCHA version 3. This time there is no box to click or puzzle to solve. But the website constantly monitors user behavior from background to figure out if it's a human or a robot. So if a user is logged into their Google account or they are normally using the same browser, they're more likely to pass the test. But if they are in incognito mode or use some VPN, they might fail the test. The website can then either block them, ask them for email verification, or keep them on hold for human review.
However, the bot makers have already taken on the new challenge. This time, not to make AIs that are more accurate than humans, but the ones that make mistakes and can fool the system. The battle between bot makers and the websites will go on as the internet keeps evolving.